So in 2005, you famously predicted certain contributors to the financial collapse. And at the time, Larry Summers and others sort of criticized you as not understanding this or being a Luddite. What worries you most about the global economic climate now?
I think there is actually very little incentive at this point for countries to produce a lot of demand of their own. And as a result, we are going to a world where each country stands on its own bottom, that we don't have the kind of flourishing of trade, at least the tendency is towards that, that we had before. And let me give an example. Think of the countries that ran large current account deficits, the emerging markets that ran large current account deficits, Turkey, Brazil, India. All of them experienced difficulty when the Feds decided that it would, you know, slow down its purchase of securities. What sort of incentive, what sort of message does it send to the world? It basically says, don't buy more from the outside than you produce. Stay within your budget. Don't contribute to global trade. Try and balance your budget. If even better, try and export more than you produce. Export more than you buy in, so that you run these surpluses. I think that message is going out both to emerging markets as well as to industrial countries. I mean, think about the countries in Southern Europe that got into trouble. Many of them were running large current account deficits, Spain, Portugal. And basically, the message that's going out is, you know, too much demand of your own is unsustainable. Balance your budget, stay within, be conservative. But be conservative means you can't buy other people's stuff. And so the world as a whole starts trying to balance its budget, universal austerity, if you will, and as a result, the level of growth is more moderate than it could otherwise be. We have to find ways to get away from this. And how do we finance countries which have large current account deficits, which are essentially importing more than they export, without them coming a cropper a few years down the line? That, to my mind, is the central problem we have.
So how crucial are these emerging markets to this problem?
I think they are important, because if you think of industrial countries, they were providing the excess demand in the last few years before the crisis. The U.S. had a huge current account deficit, right? 6% of GDP. But it can't. It's narrowing that considerably. And similarly, other countries are doing the same. So emerging markets were the source of additional demand for the world by running these large current account deficits. Now, the message that's going to them is, don't do it. Be like the countries that are balancing their budgets. Be like China. And if that is the message that's going through the world, who's there to provide the demand?